All right, everyone, welcome to another Hall of Fame interview, and we have our dear Steve Cam Vishuk, who has achieved 45% hike in less than 1 month time in career acceleration mastery. And not only that, he has got the bigger opportunity and the more responsible role as well. So let me welcome Vishuk Kunda on this special interview of Hall of Fame. Welcome, Vishuk.
Hi, Rakesh sir. Good evening. And I'm glad to be part of this Hall of Fame here with you, talking one-on-one and being interviewed by you. Glad to be here once again. And thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Vishu, first and foremost, many, many congratulations on your achievement and success.
And thank you, Rakesh sir.
Let me probably ask you a very, very simple question while we are taking your journey through the next level. What has actually inspired you to join the camp? What inspired you?
My joining camp happens to be, you know, a coincidence that I was looking for some, you know, a change of job. And this was not a planned one, me joining camp. I just got, you know, when I was going through Insta, I just got this advertisement there. I was just going through. I thought, okay, let me try this. The first session I just joined, which was the free webinar. The same time I was like, I've seen three advertisements. This was the first one I clicked. It happens to be just 2 days before the weekend session. I think it was on a Saturday we had this session. So I just joined that. And when you're giving that first 1 hour of overview, what this program is all about, I really got connected so much where this is what I've been looking for the last 1 month. When I made my profile, when I was trying to, you know, send it across, not getting calls, I thought, yes. So I remember that day I was the first one to enroll, pay and be part of join this family. So I was super excited that day when I got opportunity. I was not even knowing that there is this kind of course existing outside, that where I can join and somebody is there to guide mid-level professionals in this manner. We always feel that, you know, mid-level is something which most of the companies look at as liability. Oh, they're all done. They're all old. We don't need them anymore. Now, how to really come up and, you know, repackage yourself and take the next level. So that is exactly the juncture where I was in, and we met, and the rest is history.
Wonderful. Very nice. So even your luck works in your favor if you take the decision and action, isn't it?
Yeah. It was quick. In fact, you know, that was like, time is the essence. Me taking the session that, you know, enrolling for this course the same day, and I was the first one, as I told that day. And the very next moment I got that, the next Sunday, I was opening and going through all this. And honestly speaking, when I joined this course, I finished my first round of entry in one of the company. And I was just, the second round was scheduled for, you know, 2 days, like Tuesday or so after that weekend. And then this happened. I could not even go through all the sessions, you know, all the sections of, you know, this course. I just picked a couple of them on the how to face interviews. I cracked through. I got to know what to speak, how to present yourself. And then immediately I got my, you know, within 5 days, I got a call, you know, in the HR round. So I immediately, once I heard that, I opened the camp and I quickly gone through salary negotiation part. Though I did not follow the course order from the top, you know, the right approach, but I was, the need of the hour was how to do the salary negotiation. Mm-hmm. So that has really helped me so much. And this course was a kind of blessing in for me.
Wonderful. Very nice. See, as I have designed this course, keeping in mind the mid-level professionals, that they first get the clarity. So help us understand, what are the top three things which comes to your mind that CAM has helped you? Now that you have got the job, I'm sure you have gone through the CAM as well. So what has actually struck with you?
What has struck with me, the first thing, what I really liked going through CAM is, again, you know, I like to tell to all my friends, you know, all my CAM family and those who are seeing this, is CAM is not only for mid-level professionals. I think somebody who crossed their 10 years, they should get into CAM. CAM is not only for those people who are looking for a job outside, but it is how you design your career. It's not simply whenever you really need a job, join CAM, go through a few courses and leave it off. This is something which you need to carry with you every day, like the way your mobile phone, laptop and CAM course. That should always be with you. Because most of the topics which when I was going through the course, I see that I've been doing this, but not in a systematic approach, not in the right approach. The way the CAM course is designed right from the first chapter, it is a systematic step-by-step approach. I just jumped on directly to interviews and then salary negotiation. I know I did not do a lot of other courses. Later on, when I was going through this, I realized that if only I have joined CAM maybe 6-7 years ago, and I followed the systematic approach, the way it was defined, the way the step-by-step, it would have been a lot different for me. Maybe my salary could have been 0.5x, 1.5x. It was very easy because we've been doing the various things as part of our job, but somewhere we missed a simple thing which was being discussed very well in this CAM course. So my approach, if I have to say, is going the systematic approach and picking the right points, whichever is required, has really helped me in this CAM course.
Okay. And if you have to pick up, let's say, top three things which you could implement and which really made an impact in your career, what would that be?
My top three concepts, if I have to pick, my choice is not necessarily in the same order, but salary negotiation, because this is one area where I always feel that the mid-level people will not be able to play properly and negotiate properly. There's a very well-defined approach that you have explained in the course. So I'll say that's the first one that we need to look at. And the skill mapping, because once you cross the 10, 15 years of experience, you come there, you might have seen multiple areas, multiple teams, multiple domains you must have worked, but you don't know, you just tend to go with the tide. There could be something which is of your interest, but probably the project has ended. You may not have really put efforts to upskill in that area. But when you make the skill map, you know what are the skills you have, which one you want to pick, which one you want to focus, what is the hot skill in the market. All this you can do only when you do a proper skill mapping. The 10, 15 skills, out of which one you want to pick now, which one you want to take it further. That is the second one. And the third one is networking. Networking is very, very important, which I should honestly admit here. I have not opened my LinkedIn for last 3-4 years because I got so busy with my work. I never even bothered. There are a lot of my friends where I not even kept in touch with them. I was really surprised to see that some of my very close friends were not in my LinkedIn contacts. When I saw this course, when I started going through this, I started sending requests to people and talking to them, understanding where they are. That networking part is the third important thing which I can probably say that I liked, which I'll handpick for me.
Wonderful. Very nice. So can I also say that in the course of time that you have been in the CAM, you were able to first and foremost definitely get the result, which is really a successful one. And I think it is recorded that it is within the 1 month that you got that result, right?
Yes.
And moreover, I think I also understand that you have expanded your network, not only within the community, how the community plays a role, how the sessions, the interactions which play the role.
Community plays a role to give you a bigger visibility to a bigger picture. The market. What happens is, once you come to the middle level, you will not be able to take spare time for other activities. There has to be something which will force you to pick the time. If I have to say yes, no, probably every morning for half an hour I'm going to sit, I always think that probably 1-2 days you lose that, the flow. Whereas here, when I look at the courses, I understand that there is a systematic way where you reach out to people, which is very important. And also you tend to, probably if I can say, the way you understand what is happening around, you try to see a bigger picture, your scope to look for an opportunity will increase. instead of a small set of, you know, area, the scope for looking at opportunities will definitely go up.
Absolutely. And can I also understand, Vishu, because you have been in the mid-level and yes, there are a lot of people in the mid-level, they also feel that they are very knowledgeable. They have skills, they have knowledge, they have expertise and everything. They rely a lot of things on their certificates or their experience. What do you think is the reason for you to pick up something like a course where you have a coach mentoring you? How does it make a difference in your life?
Yes, Rakesh, let me take a simple example here. I have the best in-class ingredients with me, all the certifications, all the courses, everything. But I still need to get trained to be a better chef, how to cook. It's not just having a certificate. I have the best ingredients, but I may not end up making a wonderful dish. There has to be someone who will tell you how to use those certificates, how to use your communication skills, how to leverage on your network. A close friend of mine happens to be a vice president or a president. But if I'm not in touch with him, if I'm not leveraged my relation with him, my connect with him, I may not, you know, able to get into the next level, or I may not be able to get a good lead. So it's not just having certificates alone helps. They help only till the time you are a team member or a team lead. Absolutely. Once you go beyond a team lead level, it is multiple other parameters which will play a key role. And your hard skills, definitely, I don't undermine them. They need to be there. But having the certificates and hard skills alone will not take you anywhere. Absolutely. You should have a lot of other skills as well. That is where this course has really helped me to focus on what are the areas that were lacking in me. Where did I miss? Where did I drop the ball in the probably last 5 to 7 years?
Wonderful. And what would you advise? Like a lot of mid-level professionals actually have undergone the training by me. As far as I remember that more than 12,000 professionals have now gone through the training. But at the mid-level, there is also a tendency of people to actually not take the decision about the career. What do you want to say to them?
I probably say, because I am also one of such kind of people, as you said, till I joined the course, there's always a kind of thin line drawn between job and career. We're always doing our job. We get our salary, we get our promotion, we get our hikes. Okay, once the project is closed, we get into somewhere else. I am working for an outsourcing company. when I see that I've been working for a banking customers today, moving on to healthcare customer, moving on to logistics, moving on to telecom, you don't really plan your career. So that's where many of us miss out, because you're doing only a job, not a career. When you have a career, you will have clear goals. So coming into this kind of course will definitely help you to focus on your career more and what is required, what guides you, or what kind of guidance is required for you to design your career. So that is one thing which I think, most of the people, they don't take time for this. They feel they're all busy. But yes, spending that time is very, very important. And again, I would like to also bring here the 90-91 principle, which told in one of the sessions, that which is very, very important, the Robin Sharma's principle of 90-91. Spending that, identifying when you make your career goals, spending 90 minutes per day for 90 days will definitely take you to that one goal what you have. True. So that is one thing which I want to say.
Wonderful. And what has brought you success? What was the contributing factor to your success that you could get within 1 month the kind of success that you have always wanted? You also mentioned that you were not good in negotiation per se, or you never bothered to actually think about the money as such. So how camp played a role?
I was never saying no to money. I definitely wanted money, but I didn't knew or I didn't probably negotiate properly, putting across all the points. Mm-hmm. So the one thing is, I've been doing things. I did not probably put it properly. I did not present them properly. As what was discussed in our the 30-60-90 plan. What is it you want to do when you get into a new role? I changed it probably in my last 7 years. I changed it 4 teams where I've been doing things, but not in a systematic way, the way it has to be done. Even after I did not really present it properly. Maybe during my appraisals, what are the things you did? Okay, how did you contribute? Those aspects I missed. So that is one point where I can say I kind of missed out. And CAM has helped me a lot in those areas. So when I got that confidence, yes, I've been doing this. I'm not really leveraging on that. That's when I was doing the CAM courses, I started making a note of all those points, which all things I did. Why am I not really putting it up? I'm just doing and leaving it off. We should not do that. We should probably, you know, when you have our clearly activities that skill mapping done and look at what are the areas that we need to focus on and which are things which you have done and which you have achieved, list out all those areas. That's what I started doing in the last 1-2 months, where it helped me to update my profile and helped me to even get a new job in a very short time.
Okay. So do you think that, do you require a coach at the mid-level, or what is that actually prompted? Because a lot of people I have come across, they feel that, hey, I know all these things. Why should I know this?
It's like you're telling about me. I was under the same feeling, Rakesh. Honestly, I've been talking to my friends. Everybody feels that they're the best guide. Okay, I can guide a lot of people, but when it comes to ourselves, we always miss out on that. I can tell to a lot of my people in my team how they should do. But when it comes to me, I need someone above me or someone who knows things more than me to guide me. So somebody at lowest level, the lead can guide them. Somebody at mid-level manager, somebody above us should come, you know, and do. That could be, you know, a vice president in a company, but definitely, you know, it's not practically possible that a vice president coming and, you know, guiding a project manager level, you know, people, the manager level people. So that's when they need someone. It's like a kind of, you know, you need a catalyst. You get stuck with a lot of things and you feel that, you know, okay, if I talk to someone, they'll be able to tell me what I should do. But everybody's in the same boat, to two different ends probably, but they're sailing on the same boat. So definitely I would say that you need a coach who can show you the path. The coach will not do any magic. Okay. He'll not give you some kind of, you know, a backdoor entry into a company, or he'll not take you to any reference or anything. So what I'm going through this the course, what I felt was the points which you're telling is more of reorganizing what we know, or what I know, I felt it. You're trying to reorganize my abilities, my skills, and showing, guiding me, or showing that, you know, as a beacon, showing me the path. Definitely a coach is required at this level, because you are stuck with multiple things. A mid-level manager has to balance his team under him, and he has to handle the top management. He has to handle the customer. This is a juncture where between 15 to 20 years, you're at the crossroads. You're not gone one step up where you can start dictating completely. And you're at the level where any small mistake of team under below you, you are responsible for that. You are accountable. So one escalations will take away probably 1 or 2 days of our time. In this process, you'll not really be able to focus. Sometimes it so happens we join a course, we'll not even attend the course, irrespective of whatever amount you spend, an online course or some weekend you're supposed to go and join a some course outside. You may not be able to get time to spare for that because you're working on something, some urgent requirements, some customer requirements. So that till you cross the 30 years of experience, probably you'll get the time where you can dictate. You don't really need to be, you know, sandwich. It's kind of get conduit between two levels. You get sandwich. That is when you definitely need a help, a guide, a coach, or a mentor. That way, I think, you know, your Thursday calls that we have, the interactive sessions, they are very good in terms of, you know, sharing the ideas, sharing the views, that cross-pollination of thoughts between different people. Okay. So every time I come for the Thursday session, I keep, you know, making a note of various points that people bring up. Who knows, tomorrow I could be in the same situation where I need a similar kind of problem. I may have a similar kind of issue I may go through. So it's not so easy where, you know, I can, you know, quickly call Rakesh sir and tell that, boss, I'm into this situation. How can I come out of it? So because the questions are all there, I make a note of the questions and key important points. They are really helping me sometimes where to see that, you know, oh, okay, I made the same mistake what someone else is making. Let me do a course correction myself. Somebody in the group session has raised this point. Okay, I am also making that mistake. Let me correct it. So that kind of coaching is very, very, very much required and very helpful for us. I really got getting benefited with that, you know, the interactive sessions that, you know, you are providing for all of us.
Thank you very much, Vishu. I mean, I really appreciate the way you are consistent on those calls. Because, see, everybody has got the same opportunity. Think about the people who are more than 1,500 people are there in the camp today.
Yes.
Right? So everyone has got the same opportunity. The only people who grow faster are the people who actually grab that opportunity and consider it as a learning opportunity. Because it is very easy to overlook the things and say that, oh, I know it this. I know this, I know this, I know this. This question is not for me, not relevant. But you are not looking for, I would say, the gold mine every time. You are only looking for the golden nugget at that time. And if you can get that golden nugget every 1 hour, I mean, once in a week, I mean, nothing like it, to be very honest, to take that to the next path.
Yes. And again, you know, one more point is, there could be some things where probably, you know, the perception could be different. Somebody's thought process is different. From my industry, my approach could be different. Somebody else is having a different thing. At least being in those calls, I get to see what is happening, you know, in the logistics industry.
The market, yes.
In the market, okay. In the different, because the kind of people, the variety of people who are part of our camp course, it is like, you know, it covers a 360 degrees. True. Somebody sitting in a different industry, somebody from a different, you know, place, different country, they keep telling their experiences. We get to learn from all the experiences. See, it's like, you know, we can't make all those mistakes by ourselves. We should learn from others' mistakes, right? So when you really get an opportunity to listen, what is the kind of things they are going through, what kind of, you know, the pain they had in, you know, overcoming some of the issues, you get a lot of learning in that 1 hour class, that, you know, the session which we have.
Absolutely. And that's what we actually call the mastermind. And at that this level, this mastermind is required. The reason is, if you can't get that mastermind at this level, what happens is you will continue to make the mistake and iteration in your career.
And you don't realize that we are making a mistake.
That's a different problem altogether, right? So when you continue to make the mistake, the problem with that is that experiments get costlier.
Yes.
The learning curve actually becoming more and more steep. So you are supposed to be at this juncture, at this level of experience, but you are just lagging behind.
Yes.
That's what happens. And then people feel suffocated. Then people feel the pain. So instead of feeling the pain, I think this is the wonderful thing which we need to probably understand, that how can we mastermind and learn from each other? And that's why the theme is very clear. Let's grow together rather than just growing by only one person. Right?
Yes.
So that's the thing. So you have really, really adopted the, I would say, the value system that we are trying to build it in the camp, as we always stay by our mission that we want to help create that 25 million professionals to rise above in wealth, influence, and impact, just by giving them the world-class ecosystem. And all the success like yours, right? It actually gave me the testimony and more confidence that let me put more efforts. I'm sure many Vishus are waiting for somebody to actually tell them that how can they get to success.
Yes. Thank you so much on that. But this is one course where it should be a proactive one rather than a reactive one. people should not come, you know, at the juncture where it's almost, you know, in the last minute and try to join the course and get some quick tips and out of it. This is something it should become, you know, part of their the mid-level. Yeah. Once they cross 10 years, I would recommend my friends also, where once they cross the 10 years, be part of CAM. Because it helps you to slowly develop that, you know, building a career.
Absolutely.
That crystal clear clarity, what you gave in one of the sessions on job versus career, that is something which many people miss out. They got a job, yes, they are fired from a job, find the next job. But if they plan their career, they'll not even get into a situation where they're fired. Because they know what they're doing, where they're doing. It's like, you know, their control. Some, if you don't take control of your career, someone else will try to, you know, take control of it. So it's very simple. No, rather those people putting you in some project, you should clearly tell boss, I want this career. I want to be in this project. This is my career path. I'm interested in this. I have passion in this. If you have that clarity, once you cross maybe 10 years of experience, nothing like it. As you say that the 1.5x or 2x is nothing impossible thing to achieve.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And now we are going to increase the benchmark. We are going to raise the bar for people. Let's probably bring 100% hike for people.
It's not a difficult thing, Rakesh. I can even now confidently say that if I joined this course 7 years back, I exactly know which is that point where I missed the bus. If at that juncture, if I was part of this camp, if I can undo my 7 years or, you know, say 8 years and go back, I could have been probably, you know, in the 2x or 2.5x. I don't see that as a tough or, you know, unreasonable target or expectation.
Excellent, excellent. I'm really, really grateful for these words and really feel honored and privileged to have the community like you guys, right? Because I know that I can alone cannot change the world. But together, I know for sure that we can change the world. So this is my little bit of efforts to probably impact the lives of the people as well.
Yes, it is really helping a lot of people, especially I am the one who can say that if not for this course, I may have got a different job. I may be getting it. Again, I'm saying it's just a job. I'm not really able to make a career. When you say career, how it has to be, I may be starting now, at least, you know, it's never too late. I have started making my, you know, the blueprint, the skill mapping, all these things. So definitely down the line, 3 years, 5 years now, I know where I'm going to be. What is that, you know, I'm trying to aspire to be. I can at least plan my career going forward.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Vishu, and wish you all the best on your success and new role that you are getting into now. And I hope that we continue this journey in the camp, which you started with, and continue to learn together and grow together.
Sure, Rakesh sir. Thank you so much. And it's a great privilege to be here with you on one-to-one. And I'll continue to be on the camp course, taking all the tips and all the learning that I can get.
Thank you. Thank you very much and all the best.
Thank you. Stay safe.